वेलकम टू द 99th एपिसोड ऑफ ललिता दिव्य रहस्य सहस्रनाम स्तोत्र द अल्टीमेट कॉस्मिक एनर्जी सोर्स इन दिस यूनिवर्स प्रोवाइडिंग अनकंडीशनल नरिशमेंट विदाउट ऑल्टरिंग द ओरिजिनल कंटेंट्स और कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स विदाउट इंट्रोड्यूसिंग एनी अडल्ट्री कीपिंग द ओरिजिनल कंटेंट्स एज दे आर providing this nourishment in a smallest doses of 1,000 different forms to plants, to the rocks, to the rivers, river bodies, to the planet Earth and to the human beings all alike is the essence of Lalita Divya Rahasya Sahasranama Stotra. Next nama is Sarvavastha Vivarjita. So through this nama, faculty of mind of our early human civilization getting saturated with the air content of air content. The three states of Jagrat, Swapna, Sushupti are being taught through the application of the discretion. The colonies were formed. Human colonies were formed, and now through Sarvavastha Vivarjita, humans are exploring the new professions by utilizing their saturated faculty of mind. So it seems that humans have started applying air to make fire for cooking, as a fuel of storing warmth, etc. So there is a steady progress that is happening. Now it remains to be seen that if at all they're cooking, it's not very clear what they would be cooking, because there was nothing formed on Earth at this point in time, except the plant species, the water bodies, etc. There was not much life. Apart from that, there is some microorganism present in water, but it is very intriguing, the earliest human civilization, how they survived. What kind of food they ate, etc. There are some clues for this in Ramayana, the famous scriptures of Ramayana, Bharata, etc. In Ramayana, there are many individuals who possessed the radiance of light. This was the connection to the Mars world, because in Mars world, most of the civilization were having not blood, but they were having the radiance of light in their body. And if an individual is operating in that mode, then they are beyond taste, and probably that could be the reason why the humans, early humans, could live without food for so many for a long time. This is going to be an interesting research topic. It was discovered that the ancient the oldest DNA was found in Africa continent. Based on that the early humans were being extrapolated the time scale. But it was possible that the first inhabitants of planet Earth are beyond DNA, because they were possessing light medium instead of the blood medium. So they may be beyond genetics. So just to draw the conclusion that based on the DNA, the humans were, the early human time scale to make a projection, it doesn't reflect completeness. So this requires some further study. So just the way an infant develops its faculties and evolves, the early humans have evolved. So in this context, the development phase of an infant, if one observes, it's going to be, it's very intriguing and interesting. They are personification of beyond Maya, or they are known as Amaya. So if one wants to shatter Maya or illusion, then Amaya, innocence, is the only way. Through innocence one can shatter Maya. So in this context, the birthplace of unconditional love is innocence or Amaya. And this unconditional love prompts unconditional compassion as nourishment. So the beyond Maya prompts unconditional love, unconditional prompts unconditional compassion. So this is a cycle, and this can be seen in nature. So there is a famous song by one of the modern greats, known as P. Sushila, in language Telugu. Yavaru neerpeeramai kommaku, poolimmani remmaremmaku, yanta tondarale hari poojaku. ప్రొద్దు పొడవక ముందే పూలిమ్మని ఎవరు నేర్పేరమ్మయి కొమ్మకు పూలిమ్మని రెమ్మ రెమ్మకు. సో ఇట్స్ అమేజింగ్ హౌ ఫ్లవర్ ప్లాంట్ గివ్స్ రైస్ టు ఫ్లవర్స్ వితౌట్ అండర్గోయింగ్ అ ఫార్మల్ ట్రైనింగ్. సో దట్స్ వాట్ దిస్ సాంగ్ ఈజ్ అబౌట్. And how did this happen? Who has taught a flower plant to give rise to the flowers? So it is the same Amaya or the innocence that is beyond illusion, prompting unconditional love and unconditional compassion from Mother Earth, giving nourishment. So in this context, it is important to understand and reiterate that any soul that assumes the body, whether it is a flower plant or a human or an animal, the only reason to assume a body is to get saturated. And the fastest way to reach saturation is to shatter Maya, that means Samaya. Through innocence, one can draw unconditional nourishment in the form of unconditional love and unconditional compassion. That is the quickest way one can reach saturation. And those who succumb to Maya or illusion, they get nourishment that is adulterated, and saturation gets delayed. So in the same manner, I think it seems the early human civilization explored Mother Nature. So this beyond Maya state, they have applied the Shodasa Vidya techniques, which are being originated from lunar planet. The fragrance of Shodasa Vidya impregnated onto Earth through the Nama Dhyana Dhyatrujaya Rupa. So it is to be acknowledged that Shodasa Vidya benefits can be acquired when we try to apply them to our lifestyle and in our karmacharana. It doesn't simply mean chanting a mantra. So it is application that is important, and the application of this, the true application of Shodasa Vidya, is the innocence. So with this, this nama, this sloka is completed. That is supta pragnatmika turiya sarvavastha vivarjita. Through sarvavastha vivarjita, Suddha Vidyam Kurakara Dvijapankti Dvayodjvala re-enters onto planet Earth. So Supta, faculty of personality, Pragnatmika, faculty of intellect, Turiya, faculty of discretion, because Earth element was covered in that, and Sarvavastha Vivarjita is faculty of mind. So, hence all the four faculties have been trained. This was the second instance after the formation of the earth that all the four faculties are appearing. The first instance was Visvarupa, Jagarini, Swapanti, Taijasatmika. So, this is the second instance where all the four faculties are appearing. So, the remaining namas we will explore in the next episode. Thank you.